We're here with Eleni Kounalakis, running for Lieutenant Governor. Eleni, do you consider yourself to be a progressive, and why?
Look, I'm a former United States ambassador, and I was so proud to serve our country as an American ambassador. Mm-hmm. I'm a lifelong Democrat, liberal, progressive, fighting for all of the good ideas that our party has really advocated over the years, which have been called liberal, called progressive, called lots of things. But at the end of the day, it's really about the ideas themselves and what our party stands for. So, you know, what I think is probably the most important element mm-hmm. of being progressive in this environment, mm-hmm. frankly, is recognizing that corporate interests have become very, very powerful in our country and in our state, mm-hmm. and that the biggest frustration of the young people who are coming up and saying, hey, we're progressives, and defining themselves that way, again, at least from what I have heard being out on the campaign trail, is that they just want people who are sensible and logical and reasonable and fair, mm-hmm. and will advocate for the interests of the people over the interests of powerful corporations. And I'm a businesswoman, I have an MBA, I understand the corporate world, but I have never been part of Wall Street, Fortune 500 companies. You know, it's small and medium-sized businesses that need to have a fair shake. It's the up-and-coming entrepreneurs that need to have the opportunity. And so I think that that's why, as I've been out on the road, progressives have started referring to me as the progressive woman in the race.
That's awesome. Let me ask you one last question.
Sure.
Hypothetical. You win the election. Day one, what does Eleni do?
Day one, I am going to be opening up my office as a platform for people to communicate directly with a member of the UC Board of Regents and with the CSU Board of Trustees, because there's a real feeling out there that the public and stakeholders really don't have enough of a way in to talk to regents. They can go to the regents' meetings, but I want to be talking every single day with students, with teachers and professors and lecturers and employees and you know, everyone who really has a role to play with the CSU and the UC, to be able to have those kinds of one-on-one meetings with a member of those boards to be able to ensure that their voice is heard.
That's awesome. Where do you stand on SB 562?
Look, I'm an absolutely committed believer in universal health care. And I do believe that a single payer system is the way forward for California. And so it seems as though the bill is kind of frozen for the moment, but I believe the next governor of California is going to have to bring the stakeholders together and start working through what we need to do to deliver a single payer system. I mean, it does not appear we're going to get any kind of positive answer on universal health care from Washington, D.C. The Trump administration is doing everything they can to take a sledgehammer to the Affordable Care Act. And with this tax bill that they just passed, it seems like the next thing they want to do is figure out how to unfund Medicare.
Absolutely.
Right? So we're in big trouble if we don't go our own way in California. And I'm very much looking forward to being part of the leadership that moves California forward to universal health care and a single payer system.
Thank you so much, Eleni Kounalakis.
Thank you.
Lieutenant Governor
much.
Here
thank
at the
you.
Thank you. 28th California Democratic Convention. Good
All
luck,
right.
Eleni.